To submit or not to submit? That is the question that we're going to talk about today in this video. If you are applying to college soon and wondering whether you should be submitting your SAT or ACT scores, in this video, I'm going to talk about how you can do some personal reconnaissance on all the schools that you're applying to and make that decision on a school by school basis. My name is Brooke. I've been an independent college consultant and SAT and ACT prep tutor for over the last decade and a half. I've helped coach students to perfect scores in the SAT and ACT. You can find out more about all the things that I do at SupertutorTV.com, where you can also find our online prep courses for the SAT and the ACT. We've even had a couple of students score perfectly on the ACT using our ACT course that's been around a little longer than our SAT course. And we've had students score in the 99th percentile on the SAT and get top scores on that exam as well. So go check it out. And we have ACT prep books. Cool. On Amazon. Go check them out. We also have a totally free mailing list, supertutortv.com/subscribe, and we're on social media, so check us out there, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Finally, subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's super easy and you're already here. All right, let's do this. In terms of whether you should submit or not, this is a question that I'm getting from a lot of students because suddenly all these schools that were never test optional are suddenly test optional. In the olden days with test optional, it used to be that the only people who would go test optional were people who really feel like they bombed a particular test. But some of you might be on the border, and some of you also might be interested in knowing like whether it counts or not. Now, what I'm not really gonna do in this video is necessarily talk about whether you should study for the exams and take them, but rather if you've already got a score and you're sitting on it, whether you should submit it to a particular school or not. The first thing that you need to do in order to answer that question is you gotta familiarize yourself with the policies at each of the colleges that you're applying to. So once you have your college list up and ready, I encourage you to go to that college's website, first figure out, does this college super score, right? If so, their data points are going to be super score data points, not just an individual sitting. If they don't super score, those data points are going to be from an individual sitting. From whatever they accept or whatever they call their process, that's what's going to be in those charts. So make sure you figure that out first. And then the next thing that you want to do is you want to figure out the data. Where do you find the data? How do you find the data? What is the data? Well, you can Google 25th to 75th percentile in the title of the school. And that's one way you can do it. But you got to be a little bit careful because when you do that, sometimes you're going to get sent to random websites that have like collated this information for you. And sometimes their data might be 5 years old. You never know. So if you want the most accurate information, the most up-to-date information, your best source is the schools themselves and their web pages, or something called the common data set. And in that common data set, there is a place where they're going to tell you the 25th to 75th percentile of admitted students. So I'm going to pull up a common data set right now. I just pulled up the University of Connecticut's common data set from 2018 to 2019. I'm going to show you how to use this. University of Connecticut has announced it's going to go on a trial of the test optional model for 2 years because of COVID-19. So even though they didn't used to be test optional, they are test optional now. You've got to understand that the common data sets you're going to be looking at potentially are not going to reflect a test optional policy. And what we probably will see over the course of the next year is as schools go test optional, all of their average test scores are probably going to shoot up. Because when you go test optional, you basically convince all the kids who are at the lower end of the totem pole to hide their scores. And when you hide those lower test scores, it seems like everybody you admit is smarter. And so that's kind of cool, right? Okay, so how do we read this? You're gonna scroll down, essentially, guys, and you're looking for admission information. You can just do like a text search for SAT or ACT and you'll get down to this section. And this is kind of the money shot right here that I use for my decision-making tool. The number one thing that I'm looking at is my percentiles on your SAT, your ACT, this kind of good stuff. If you have a school that's always been test optional, you can actually look at this number. And this is kind of interesting and you can see whether people are submitting one test or the other. So you can see here, University of Connecticut, the 25th percentile is a 600 and the 75th percentile is a 690. What I like to say is anytime you're at the 50th percentile and above for this stuff, 100% you should be submitting your scores. They will help you more than hurt you because over half the class has scores that are in your range. Now, if you're from the 25th to this 50th percentile, there are maybe a few groups of people who I wouldn't necessarily recommend submit, especially if you're right at that 25th percentile. But for the most part, if you're above the 25th percentile, you're probably safe submitting your test scores, and it's probably stronger to submit them versus not to submit them in general. That's my general rule of thumb. If you're scoring below the 25th percentile, that's when I start to say, why submit them? If you've got below a 1200, I would probably go test optional and pretend like you didn't take the thing. Because this 20%, whenever you're looking at like the lowest 20% of people admitted to a school in any particular metric, those people aren't getting in because of their test scores. Like, they're not helping them at all. They're getting in spite of their test scores. So just don't turn it in. Why shoot yourself in the foot? They're going to look at other stuff more. And this is like one particular year where they're going to assume, well, maybe you didn't take the SAT because you're afraid of getting COVID-19 and you live with your grandma. You know, you never know. Now, if you're right at the 25th percentile mark or you have a lopsided score, that's when things get a little bit more complex. So let's talk about that really quickly. So let's say you wanted to apply to UConn and you had a 590 on your reading, but you had an 800 on your math. You might be so proud of that amazing math score that it might be fine to just go ahead and submit it. But given that COVID has made everything test optional, a better option for someone like you might be to take the SAT math subject test, try to ace that thing, and if you can get a perfect 800 on that, you know what? Then maybe you can just not submit your SAT score and submit your SAT math score, apply to your engineering program, and be like, hey, I'm really smart at math. Here's my 5 on the calculus AP exam. Here's my 800 on the SAT subject test. And you can kind of bury that reading and writing score that isn't so great in sub 600, right? Cool. So that's another tactic that you might use. And then you can kind of hide this if you have some other proof that you're really awesome at math. There are some groups that I like to say should maybe adjust their parameters on this a little bit more. And so let's talk about those groups. If you are applying to college and you are from an underrepresented group, or you're from a high school that typically the performance on standardized tests is lower than the average performance at other high schools, you can be a little bit more forgiving in terms of what scores you're submitting. Let's say most of the people at your high school get like 900s on the SAT, and you roll out and you get like a 1200, and you are so proud of that 1200, but guess what? That 1200 is 10 points below the 25th percentiles at UConn. You still might want to submit that score because it's not a bad score for somebody in your context. That being said, again, like, it's not going to hurt you to leave it out. If you are below that 25th percentile, it might help you, in fact. So no shame, you don't have to submit it. Other groups in terms of submissions, international students. It's really hard for American colleges to feel confident in admitting international students if they don't really know your high school. And a lot of times it's hard for colleges in the US to know the profile of every single high school in every single country in the world. And the standardized tests become a tool that college admissions officers can use to try to figure out whether you are up to snuff. Therefore, if you're an international student, I generally say that if you can submit a test score and it shows your abilities, you really should be submitting it. You're one group that I definitely would encourage to try to take these tests, because if you have it, it's going to help you more than, say, it will help a domestic student potentially. And if you don't have it, schools are going to assume that you're scoring below the 25th percentile a lot of the time. It doesn't mean that you are, and it doesn't mean that you don't have extenuating circumstances because of COVID that prevent you from taking these. And if you do, then do what you can. But if you don't prove yourself with a test, you have to prove yourself somewhere else, as I've always said in my other videos as well. Finally, if you go to an extremely competitive high school, and like your high school, you know, let's say you go to Gunn High School in Palo Alto, and I think they have the highest ACT average score of any high school in the nation, right? And everybody at your high school is like totally crushing these tests, like the ACT, and like everybody from your high school is applying to one particular college that you know of, and everybody's going to have these amazing ACT scores, and yours is going to be a little bit on the lower side, even if you're at that 25th percentile or a little bit above. You might be the kind of person who might want to go test optional, and it might look better to omit them if they're discrepant with your GPA or with the way that everybody else at your high school is scoring, because those are the people you're going to be compared with when they get that pile in to the admissions office and that admissions officer is reading them. Usually people read applications together. So they're going to read like this lump of like a whole state together, a whole city together, a whole high school together, right? They're going to read everybody from your high school kind of at once and make a decision. So not every college does that, obviously, but a lot of colleges do. So it's just something to keep in mind as well. And then I would also say that a lot of the reason that people go test optional is that you guys just don't want to put in the time and the work and the studying, because you know you're like the kind of person who like freaks out on test day and like doesn't always give his all or give his best. And you don't want to have to deal with the stress of it. And COVID came along and it made it easy to just say, you know what, I'm not dealing with that. And if that's you, and like, honestly, you're the kind of person who you're like, give me wow factor any day, give me essay writing any day, I can write an essay and wow their socks off with that. I have some really cool activities nobody else I know does, but tests aren't like your thing. this is the year to skip them and to not submit them. But hopefully that helps you guys kind of understand whether you should submit or not. Now, the other thing you can look at is school's own websites. And sometimes the website of school is going to tell you even more information about who they accept and when they accept them and all that kind of good stuff. So I can go to Princeton, for example, and look up their admission statistics. And most colleges also are going to have this kind of stuff. And look, they're going to give me a different stat. Look, they give me the 50% SAT scores. Okay, so we've got 750 to 800 and 710 to 770. But you can kind of get a feel for what they're accepting, who they're accepting, and some different statistics sometimes if you go to their site directly. But there you go. There's my basic advice. 25th percentile and above, you're probably okay. Definitely submit it if you're 50th percentile above. And this means that you're going to have a different policy for test submission depending on where you're applying, right? When you apply to Princeton and Stanford, you might be like, I'm not showing you my SAT score. But then if you apply to the University of Connecticut, maybe you think, oh yeah, I'm definitely showing you my 1300. Here you go, right? So depending on where you're applying, it might change your story on whether you're going to put the test score with that particular application or not. And that's totally normal and totally cool. And in any case, I wish you guys luck with your applications. Let us know, are you going test optional? Are you taking the test? What's your goal? Are you going to submit? Are you not going to submit? Are you submitting to half the schools you're applying to and not the other half? Tell us in the comments, and I will see you guys next time on SupertutorTV. Thanks for watching.